إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، أوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل. وكيف تدركون التقوى؟ أو service of Allah, I advise you with the taqwa of Allah عز وجل. And how can you accomplish taqwa? O servants of Allah, indeed, from the things and the rulings that are repeated over and over again in the Quran is the commandment of Allah Azza wa Jal بالإنفاق والصدقة, is the command of Allah Azza wa Jal that you spend and you give in charity. And indeed, Allah Azza wa Jal all too often in the Quran, He made this spending a characteristic of the people of taqwa. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Alif Lam Mim, that is the book, there's no doubt in it, of guidance for those who have taqwa, those who have iman in the ghayb and established the salah. And from what we provided them, some of what we provided them, they spend. Allah Azza wa Jalla clarified that from the characteristics of the people of taqwa is that they spend some of what Allah Azza wa Jalla has provided them. And He did so that they might understand that iman is not complete. One's iman has a deficiency if he doesn't come with the quality of spending in the path of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, clarifying who those who have iman are, and talking to those individuals, commanding them if they have iman, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ يَوْمٌ لَا بَيْعٌ فِيهِ وَلَا خُلَّةٌ وَلَا شَفَاعَةٌ وَالْكَافِرُونَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says to those who have iman, O you who have iman, spend from what we have provided for you before it comes to you a day. Before a day comes, should I say, before a day comes when there's no bartering in that day. There's no buying and selling on that day. وَلَا خُلَّةٌ, there's no friendship on that day. وَلَا شَفَاعَةٌ, and there's no intercession on that day. وَالْكَافِرُونَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ, and the kuffar, they are the wrongdoers, they are the oppressors, they are the unjust. Allah Azza wa Jalla yuhiffukum, He encourages you, and embarrasses you with spending for what he provided for you before a day comes when there's no intercession. لا يتكلمون إلا من أذن له الرحمن. A day when no one will speak except those Allah has given permission to. A day when there's no friendship. لا خلة لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغني. Everybody will have an affair that busies him on that day. ولا بيع. And there's no selling on that day. Even though on that day an individual would wish that he could sell everything in this dunya just to be successful. يبصرونهم يود المجرم لو يفتدي من العذاب يومئذ ببنيه وصاحبته وأخيه وفصيلته التي تؤويه ومن في الأرض جميعا ثم ينجيه كلا. On that day, an individual would sell the most expensive things that he had to save himself from the punishment of Allah. He would love that he'd buy his freedom selling his own son, his companion, his wife, and his brother, and his whole tribe, his whole family that protects him. And everyone that's in the earth just so he could be safe. Kalla, indeed, no. There's no selling on that day of judgment. The day when you stand in front of your Lord, Yawm al-Qiyamah. Today is the day of barter. Today is the day of purchasing. Because on that day, Yawm al-Qiyamah, Yawm al-Deen. That day is the day of deen. يوم الجزاء يوم توفى إليكم أعمالكم. The day when your actions will be paid back to you. يقول الله عز وجل وما تنفقوا من خير فلأنفسكم وما تنفقون إلا ابتغاء وجه الله وَمَا تُنْفِقُونَ مِنْ خَيْرٍ يُوَفَّى إِلَيْكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تُظْلَمُونَ. Whatever you spend from good, then it benefits yourself. And you should not spend except seeking the face of Allah. And whatever you spend from good, then it will be returned back to you and you will not be oppressed in the least. هكذا يوم الجزاء هكذا يوم الدين وما أدراك ما يوم الدين. This is the day of recompense. This is the day you will be paid back. And what will let you know what is that day that you will be paid back? The word deen مشتقة من الدين. The word deen is derived from the word day. So all of you are lenders, all of your creditors, and on that day you will be paid back. So what is this loan that you should give? What is this loan that you have an opportunity to give now? If we look in the speech of Allah, we find that Allah Azza wa Jalla said something clearly. من ذا الذي يقرب الله قربا حسنا فيضاعفه له أضعافا كثيرا والله يقبض ويبسط وإليه ترجعون. يقول الله عز وجل who is the one who will give Allah a good loan so he can multiply it for him to many a fold. And Allah, he holds back and he gives, and to him you will return. This is the loan that you should give, that you might be paid back on the day debts are paid back. وَمِنَ الْأَسَفِ from the things that we find and are too ashamed and sad about is that from us are those individuals يَتَعَامَلُونَ بِالْرِبَى that like acting with interest. They like to act with interest in order to take a profit. And any time they find a way to get profit in their money,
then they embark on that even if it's not halal. But when it comes time to give sadaqah, when it comes time to give charity, يتوقفون, they stop, they hold themselves back. وما آتيتم من ربا ليربو في أموال الناس فلا يربو عند الله. وما آتيتم من زكاة تريدون وجه الله فأولئك هم المضعفون. And what you give from riba to get a profit or to get increase in what the people have, فلا يربو عند الله, then that won't increase, that won't get you any profit with Allah. وما آتيتم من زكاة, but what you give from زكاة, تريدون وجه الله, seeking out the face of Allah, then it is this that will be increased. This is what will be increased for the servant, Ya Abdullah. But from the people are those who the shaitan takes advantage of. And he causes them to fear when it's time to give in charity. When it's time to give sadaqah, he tricks them and he puts poverty in front of their eyes. And he makes them forget about the fact that Allah is Al-Razzaq, that Allah is Al-Ghani, that Allah is Wasi', Wasi'un Aleem, Aleemun bima taf'alun. He is generous in what he gives. He is your provider. He is the one who is free of need. The one who is like this made giving him a loan, made the example of charity like giving him a loan, although he is free of need. This shows you how great and important this is. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, advising and encouraging you and reminding you to not be fearful of the shaytan. He says, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثْلِ حَبَّةٍ كَمَثْلِ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلْ فِي كُلِّ سُنْبُلَةٍ مِئَةُ حَبَّةٍ والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم. Allah Azza wa Jalla says the example of those who spend their money in the path of Allah is like the example of a grain or a seed of corn. أنبتت سبع سنابل, that comes up with seven ears or seven stalks, and every stalk is 100 kernels, and Allah increases from where he works. And Allah is wasi', he is vast and bountiless in what he gives. Aleem, knowledgeable about what you do in order to repay you for it. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَمَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ وَتَثْبِيتًا مِنْ أَنْفُسِهِمْ كَمَثْلِ رَبْوَةٍ أَصَابَهَا وَابِلٌ فَآتَتْ أُكُلُهَا ضِعْفَيْنِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يُصِبْهَا وَابِلٌ فَطَلٌّ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَفْعَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, in the example of those who spend their money seeking the pleasure of Allah is like the example of a high level or a highly elevated piece of land. أصابت أصابها وابلٌ, that was touched or that had a great rainfall poured down on it. Seeking the pleasure of Allah and to strengthen and fortify their own self is like the example of a high raised piece of land that is touched by a wabil or a strong rain. فَآتَتْ أُكُلُهَا ضِعْفَيْنِ, so it gives its crops twice fold. And if it's not touched by this wabil or this intense rain for fun, then it is still given a small amount of moisture that makes it sufficient. And Allah is well known and Allah is all seeing about what you do. This is the example of sadaqah, that it will be increased for you. And if nothing else, then it will not harm you in the least. So what is the reason, O servants of Allah, that we hold back when it's time to give? In spite of the fact that we know that in giving, our affairs will be made easy. But in stinginess is everything made hard. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَذَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فسنيسره للعسرى. Why hold back, O servant of Allah, when Allah says, as far as the one who gives and has taqwa and believes in what is good, then we will make his affairs easy. We will facilitate him to eat. But as far as the one who is stingy and arrogant and denies what is good, then we will facilitate him to hardship. Why hold back? Why not give? When Allah has promised you happiness when you give, وَسَيُجَنَّبُهَا الْأَتْقَى الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَالَهُ يَتَزَكَّى وَمَا لِأَحَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجْزَى إِلَّا بِتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى وَلَسَوْفَ يَرُضَى. Like this, O servant of Allah's happiness, as well, he will be safer from it, the one who has taqwa. الَّذِي يُؤْتِي مَالَهُ يَتَزَكَّى, the one who gives his money in purifying it, in charity. وَمَا لِأَهَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجْزَى, and he's not doing it and no one has any rewards or favors that he's paying back. إِلَّا بِتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى, except for the fact that he's seeking the pleasure of his Lord. وَلَسَوْفَ يَرَضَى, then he will be happy, he will soon be happy. هَكَذَا يَا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. So give, or you have iman, give, and don't let the shaytan trick you. And don't believe in what he promises you from poverty. And believe in the promise of Allah. The shaytan is tricking you. As Allah Azza wa Jalla said, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا إِنَّمَا يَدْعُوا حِزْبَهُ لِيَكُونُوا مِنْ أَصْحَابِ الصَّعِيرِ. Verily the shaytan is an enemy to you, so take him as an enemy. Verily he calls his followers to be from the inhabitants of the hellfire. So what is this call of the shaitan? And what is this promise of Allah that I tell you to believe in and not be misled by the shaitan? Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْفِقُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَمِمَّا أَخْرَجْنَا لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ ولا تيمموا الخبيث منه تنفقون ولستم بآخذيه إلا أن تغمضوا فيه إن الله غني حميد. الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمر بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا والله واسع عليم. الله عز وجل says, O you who have iman, spend from the good of what you have earned and what we have brought out for you from the earth, and don't seek out that which is nasty from it to spend that. Don't seek out the least, don't seek out the nasty to spend that, even though you wouldn't take it unless you had to close your eyes to do so. And Allah is the free of need, the worthy of praise. It is shaitan that promises you poverty and he commands with wickedness, but Allah, he promises with forgiveness and extra or bounty from him. And Allah is vast and all-knowing. So whoever of you wants an increasement, whoever of you wants extra, whoever of you wants mubarakah in his property, in his money, in his reward, in this life and in the life to come, for صَدِّقُوا وَتَصَدَّقُوا, then believe in Allah and give generously. For indeed you have nothing to worry about. So in, like the Prophet said, مَا نَقَسَ مَالٌ مِّن صَدَقَةٌ, money has never been decreased because of صَدَقَةٌ. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has promised you, so he said, وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, and if you had gratitude, I would increase you. So seek out the increasement of Allah, servants of Allah, that you might obtain piety. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على نبيه الذي اصطفى محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه وبعد. O servants of Allah, indeed Allah Azza wa Jalla has made sadaqah a way of proving your iman. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَالصَّدَقَةُ burhan, and charity is a proof. I have proof on the truthfulness and the validity of one's iman. But there are from the people those who still refrain from giving charity. And they say, let others give. Or they say, I don't have. Or they say, what I have is too small. But we should understand that taqwa and iman and righteousness is accomplished in giving charity. We read the ayah, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And some of what we have provided them, they spend. This is the affair of the people of taqwa. And Allah Azza wa Jal, we should pay attention to this ayah. Because Allah says, وَمِمَّا. And some of what we have provided them. Allah Azza wa Jal, He doesn't want it all. He only wants that you pay some and spend some of what He provided you. And He reminds you in this ayah that it is He who provided you with it. You did not earn it on your own. It wasn't because you were smart. It wasn't because you got the bachelor's and master's and doctorate. It wasn't because you have a good career that you were provided. Indeed, your provision came from Allah, Ar-Razzaq, the provider. Allah reminds you about that like He gave it to you, then likewise you should give. And He tells you that you will not obtain righteousness until you do so. وَلَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. And you will not obtain righteousness until you spend from that which you love. But there are still people who think that they can get righteousness without spending. Indeed, O servants of Allah, it's necessary that we understand these facts. It's necessary that we strive in spending in the path of Allah. There's another group of people who we find them all the time. Jihad, mubaharat, thawrat, i'tisamat, all the time. Jihad. But it's as if they don't remember that in the Quran, in every time, except one, Allah gives precedence for jihad with many over jihad with your life. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, hal adullukum ala tijaratin. Tijara, today is the day of buying and selling. Tunjikum min azabin aleem. Tu'minuna billahi wa rasulihi wa tujahidun fi sabilillahi bi amwalikum wa anfusikum. O you have iman, shall I not inform you of a trade, of a transaction that will save you from the punishment? That you have iman in Allah and His Messenger, and that you perform jihad in the path of Allah with your money and your life. This reminds me of these people. They talk about siyasa, they talk about intikhabat, they talk about the rulers, and they go off on these falsehoods that they go off on. But it reminds me of a statement, and I'm paraphrasing, of one of our scholars, Sheikh Hamid al-Uthman, when he talked to us about Osama bin Laden, the one who passed away. And he reminded us that what would have been the case if he had spent all of that effort and all of that money and all of that time in the building of masajid and in the foundation or in the founding of schools to teach Tawheed and to teach the Sunnah, what would the result have been? The result would have been multitude times greater than what he came with, if he came with any good at all. Like this, O servants of Allah, these people who call you all the time, we should remember that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first thing he did was establish the masjid. Masjid Quba wa masjid al-Nabawi. Hakadha al-jihadu bil-mal. Like this is how you fight with your money, establishing tawheed in the people. Because the fighting with the sword is only a means. And the goal is that the speech of Allah be raised high. So, O servants of Allah, I say to you in closing, encouraging you to spend in the path of Allah. And don't hold back your hands. And give. And have knowledge. وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ يُوَفَّى إِلَيْكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تُظْلَمُونَ. And have knowledge that whatever you spend from good, then it will be returned back to you. And you will not be wrong in the least. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ.